So in today's plant of the day video, I'm gonna talk about a beautiful house plant. This house plant have been already been featured in my top 10 hardy house plants. If you haven't visited that video, I will give that video link on the top right. So in today's video, I'm gonna talk about this Peperomia, and there are different cultivars of Peperomia are available in the market. So this variety of Peperomia is known as Peperomia opticifolia. This is the variegated version of opticifolia, Peperomia opticifolia, because you can see that the new leaves and some of the older leaves have got beautiful yellow color variegation. This is the common Peperomia that you can easily found out in any online sites and also in your local nurseries. Talking about this plant, so this is a popular Peperomia species, and basically this belong to the Papiracea family. This plant basically belongs to the Central and South America, including Mexico, Florida, Caribbean. Talking about this plant, I have been growing this plant for at least 2 years now, and you can see that my plant is really doing very well and it have got some drastic growth. My plant really needs some repotting and also some dressing. You can see that it have got two stems, and in the middle section of the plant there is also some new growth. So my plant really needs some pruning now, and I really like to propagate it. So in my future videos, I'm gonna upload a video regarding the proper way how you can propagate your Peperomia opticifolia variegated version. As like the normal version of Peperomia opticifolia, this have got same cup-like dark green leaves. Also, you can see that the leaves are very shiny and also very fleshy like succulents. So this plant is very drought tolerant plant. You can leave this plant as it is for at least 15 to 10 days without even watering this plant. And also it have got shiny leaves, so you always have to keep in mind to keep the leaves clean so that it can absorb much amount of sunlight. Talking about the variegation, you can see that the older leaves have got light colored green variegation through the foliage. Like the other Peperomias, this plant also blooms, but the blooms are not that attractive. Talking about the basic things while growing this Peperomia opticifolia variegated version, so the first thing is lighting conditions. So you can keep this plant in bright and direct sunlight, and even this plant can tolerate low light conditions sometimes. But in that condition, you have to keep in mind that you have to rotate this plant time to time so that it have got all over growth. However, if you place your plant in bright direct sunlight, then you can also face some kind of leaf problems, like leaf burns. On contrary, if you doesn't give your plant bright light, so it may lose some kind of variegation from its leaves as well. Talking about the feeding and watering your plant, so these have got succulent kind of leaves as I told you earlier, and as you can see, so this plant does well if you overwater your plant. So these plants needs watering like a typical cacti. And whenever you water your plant, make sure that to check the soil mixture. If you see that the soil mixture is on the wetter side, so let this plant as it is for at least 3 to 4 days. After that, check the soil mixture once again, and after that you water your plant. And the watering is totally depends on what kind of soil mixture you have used. So you should use a soil mixture which is basically used for cacti. So the soil mixture I usually use for this plant is the mixture of cocopeat, perlite, river sand, and this is the basic soil mixture that I usually use for most of my indoor plants. As far as fertilizing goes, this plant doesn't need that much of fertilization, but I once a month fertilize it with organic vermicompost, and also sometimes I use NPK for this plant. But if you want, you can also use a dilute liquid fertilizer in its growing season, like this is the spring season, so you can fertilize your plant time to time. This is the drought tolerant plant and also the lowest maintenance plant, but you can easily kill this plant if you haven't used a well-drained soil for this plant. You can use any kind of soil mixture for this plant, but make sure that the soil is well-drained regardless of the soil type. Talking about the transplanting, so this plant doesn't need that much of transplanting because this plant have got very small root system. But if you see that your plant has outgrown its current pot, so in that condition your plants really need repotting. So use a new bigger pot. Just make sure that the pot or the container you are gonna use for this plant is not that big. Also, the pot should be shallow to prevent any kind of issues like waterlogging. As far as grooming and maintenance goes, so these plants' leaves and also the stems may overgrow over time. So you can lightly prune the stems to maintain a compact look. You can see that I have pruned it and also got some stems to get my new peperomia pot. So in my next videos, I'm gonna show you the proper way how you can repot your Peperomia opticifolia variegated version. So friends, that's all for today's video. See you in my next video. Until then, stay safe, stay happy. Thanks for watching. Bye.